Hi guys, and welcome to another music reaction here on this channel. Holy shit. I'm sitting in the middle of nowhere. I'm on a field, and the sun is shining. It's spring, finally. In a few days it's starting to rain again, so I thought I'd use this opportunity to get out again. And we are listening to new music again, and music that is so fitting for this environment. Can you hear the birds chirping? Holy shit. It's beautiful. The sun is coming out as I'm starting to do this video. It's amazing. By Noah Cyrus. One of my favorite artists. It's so surprising. I love Miley. Miley's obviously my favorite artist, but Noah is like really, really close. She's amazing. I never really paid attention to her music over the last few years, but like last year when I got so high that I saw Jesus came out, and then she released the EP End of Everything, which was, I think it was my favorite record of last year. The End of Everything was amazing. The EP, the entire EP is amazing. Every song of it, it just was the perfect summer music, the perfect summer mood in a way. It was amazing. I loved it. And now she came out with another EP called People Don't Change. And I think there's somebody coming. Lord, no. Okay, let's set the camera back up and listen to some fucking music. Some kind of bird flying over your head. Maybe it's not an eagle. We don't have eagles here, but what? Ein Greifvogel, wie man im Deutschen sagt. A big Greifvogel. She released one single of this EP so far, and that was Dear August, featuring PJ Harding. And that was a great song. It reminded me a lot of Lonely. I heard that one before, but I have no idea what to expect from the rest. So we're going to listen to it. And we start with Dear August.
Slowly, why is the morning come so slowly? When I got no one to hold me.
My drunk heart. So I take all of my wasted love. Baby, now the summer heat is fading. Oh. I don't know where this road is headed anymore.
Such a beautiful song. Like, see, she started doing like this pop, dance pop music in 2016 with stuff like Stay Together or Make Me Cry. And yeah, that was nice, and I also like those songs, but this is just so different. And the vibe is so amazing. It's like, it's perfect for sitting here, just being outside, that country flair. It's making me feel so warm and so at home and comfortable. And this big bird, I'm really scared that he might attack me. I'm not something you can check. Why? What are you? I'm really scared right now, he might attack me any second. Their voices work perfectly together. I don't know if they have collaborated before, I'm not sure. Okay.
The way you look when you cry made me wanna confess to you. And there's no reason keeping secrets, cause you belong to somebody else.
So far, very beautiful, very beautiful. I think I misread the title, because the title is You Belong to Somebody Else, not You Belong to Somebody. Noah is just always so good with her lyrics. Like, I think my favorite song was Young and Sad. That was amazing.
I give you pieces of my secrets.
The one line, it's easier to let a heart wait than make a heart break. I think so too. Like, just wait. Just wait. Maybe it will work again. Maybe.
Cold and sweet hell upon myself. You belong to me.
Whoa. No! Not the whistling. I love it. Ah. What are they called in English? Ladybug. She had the whistling in, I think, Lonely or July. I think it was July. And I remember her saying that Noah can't whistle. She can't whistle. So every time she has to perform the song live, she's doing something else but not whistling. Do I taste good? I hope so. I'm a snack. Ouch, you hurt me, actually. I mean, there's not much to interpret or anything. It's just pretty obvious. It's a song about realizing that two people are not meant to be together and you belong to somebody else. Like, Cannonball is the next one. Let's see what we get here. Oh, some advertisement first, of course.
Stumble back home and leave the door open. 6 a.m. I fall into bed.
Sounds like a lullaby in a way. Do you know what I mean? It sounds like a lullaby.
And keep doing this night after night. I don't want this anymore. But my heart's a cannonball.
Oh.
People don't change.
And there we have the title of the EP. Okay. Okay. Wait, let me analyze the lyrics. I don't want this anymore, but my heart's a cannonball dragging me under the waves. People don't change. Pulling you down all the time because your heart, like, you're staying in that relationship and you're staying... I'm stuck with my foot. And you're staying with that person because your heart is so attached to that person, so heavy that it drags you down anytime. Mm.
Cold indifference to waves. People don't change. No, I don't. People don't.
No change? Oh, I thought there would be a very dramatic change at the end. I love it. It's cute. I love it. It's, I think the vibe is still a bit different to the end of everything. It sounds, sonically, not the same, but close. But I think it's slower. Like, last year we had some nice bops, actually. Like, I mean, Young and Sad, it's a sad song. And also, like, stuff like, Liar. I mean, it's sad, but it's also, at the same time, there are songs you can really sing along to and really, like, feel and scream a little bit, inside at least. These are much more, like, calm and relaxing, which is great. It's a great, like, sound to create a specific kind of environment or, like, ambient in a way. So it's great to just sit around and listen to it to create a mood. We have The Best of You, Slow Train Coming, and The Worst of You. Oh, The Best of You and The Worst of You. Oh, wait.
He said, no, my love, that's not the moon. That's God's fingernail. He's pointing at you. Oh, it says songs the whole night through. As the stars look on, stormy.
That was different from what I expected. I don't know what I expected, but it was... Is it a bunny or is it a deer? It looks like a deer. Hello. Hello, deer. Oh. No, it's a deer. It has to move its head down to eat. It's a deer. I have to listen to it again.
There
was a squirrel. Oh my god. I'm in the middle of nature, here are so many animals, it was a squirrel! I'm very intrigued to see what The Worst of You is about, because I could imagine it's like mirroring that song.
I see the slow train coming by the phone, a slowly breaking heart.
I like that. Ooh, yes. Aww. I like the bridge very, very much. And now I'm waiting by the phone, a slowly breaking heart that knows you're gonna make me lonesome when you go. Well, sad. But yes, I like the line, a slowly breaking heart that knows you're gonna make me lonesome when you go. I sold my heart for stolen gold. I played my part, so I suppose you're gonna make me lonesome when you go. I played my part, so it's over. Like, you've done everything you could. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. I wanna listen to the bridge again. That was my favorite part of the song. I don't know what my phone is trying to tell me, but the amount of Bundeswehrwerbung is not nice. I don't know. Do I look like I want to join the army? No, I don't. Do I look like I could be helpful for the army? No, I don't. Would I die on the first day of training? Yes, of course. So why do you... Which FBI agent is sitting there thinking like, oh yeah, we're going to spam him with advertisement for the army. That's it. Yes. He will like that. No. You're just gonna make me hate you even more. Need the lyrics. I like that Noah has all of the lyrics in her video description on YouTube. That's great. Nice guitar again. I like that.
Are you capable of driving home tonight?
Well, the visualizer is cute.
Handed you another chance to disappoint me, and again you did me wrong.
I don't like that. I know. This is too... Oh, God.
Feels like all I am to do is pay for your excuses to buy a little time. I don't know why I... You're never gonna change, hell, you're never gonna try. Why am I still trying to prove that I can love the worst of you?
First of all, that song is way too accurate. Like, I think many people can understand it. I don't think it has to be about a relationship, it's just about, like, a romantic relationship. I think it can be about any kind of relationship, like, people just being... dickheads, and you're like, okay, you have an excuse, okay, great, like, let's have a little bit more time together, and then you give them another chance to disappoint me, and they're doing it all over again, and you're like, well, dumb. I mean, I like it, but I don't like that the song is, like, talking about this problem, because I hate this. I hate it so much. I hate it when people behave like shit, and you're like, but I don't want to lose you. I don't want to lose control. Chorus.
It feels like all I have to do is pay for your excuses to buy a little time. So why am I still trying to prove that I can love the worst of you? I do the worst of you. I do.
So why am I still trying to prove that I can love the worst of you? And then the end is all about I do, I'll always love the worst of you. I do, I always love the worst of you. Finally was capable of loving the worst of him, you know?
Feels like all I can do is laying here.
What a beautiful EP. What a beautiful body of work. I love it very much. Okay, so number one is Dear August. Number two is The Worst of You. Number three is You Belong to Somebody Else. Then I would say Cannonball, followed by Slow Train Coming, and then The Best of You. Or maybe change Cannonball and Slow Train Coming. I think this is going to be a great summer with new Noah Cyrus music. And she's really, like, she's a great summer artist, because her music feels so fresh and so, like, light in a way. And we'll see each other soon for another music reaction.